Before we actually start doing confidence or hypothesis testing, there's several things we need to talk about first. And first is the hypothesis statement. We have to set this thing up. A hypothesis statement is a statement that something is believed to be true. A hypothesis test is a process by which a decision is made between two opposing hypotheses. These two opposing hypotheses are known as the null hypothesis and the alternative. These are two hypothesis statements that oppose each other. Now, the null hypothesis, which we denote by H naught, is a statement of, and the way I think of it, as the status quo. In other words, it's a statement of what we already accept to be true. Now, in this cancer example that I talked about earlier, we will be assuming that the new treatment is no better than the old, and we're going to be looking for something to contradict that. So the null hypothesis, the statement that the new treatment is no better than the old, will be H naught, the null hypothesis, is mu, the true mean, is equal to 2.25. Now the alternative hypothesis, which we denote by H sub A, this is what we think of as the research hypothesis. This is the hypothesis a researcher is typically trying to suggest is more likely. Than the null hypothesis. So for the cancer research, we write the statement as HA, the alternative hypothesis, is that the true mean is greater than 2.25. Now, as a technical note, the way you find this in many textbooks, and the way TC Stats allows you to do this, is if the alternative is the mean is greater than 2.25, then technically the null should be that the mean is less than or equal to 2.25, because combined these cover all possible combinations. Now, the way I teach this, and the way I prefer my students to think of this, is to ignore this, and I always make the null hypothesis equal. Too often, I found that students get really confused over should this one be greater than or equal to, or should be just greater than, or should be. It gets really confusing between these inequalities. So, by making the null hypothesis always equal, that will never change the result of a hypothesis test. This is the key right here for calculating the probability. And TC Stats will allow for this. So this is the way I highly recommend my students do it. The null hypothesis always make equal to the believed value, and then the state the alternative hypothesis, whether you think that because of research that your mean is really bigger than what was used to be believed. Now, something very important to note here, that nowhere in here do you see a sample statistic. Nowhere in the null or the alternative hypothesis do you see any result from a sample. Notice the value of the sample statistic does not show up in the null or alternative hypothesis, nor does a symbol for any statistics. Nowhere in here do I see an X bar. There are no X bars in here. The hypothesis test is about population parameters. They're not about sample statistics. They are not about sample statistics. So sample statistics will never ever show up here, either by symbol or by value. So just as a quick recap on that cancer research, I would say the null hypothesis is that the mean is equal to 2.25 because that's what had been reported. The alternative hypothesis, because I think my process or my treatment is better, is that the mean is actually bigger than 2.25. And ultimately, what I would do is I will compare X bar, which was, I believe, 3.31, if I remember correctly. I will compare that with this using the standard deviation and sample sizes to make a determination how far apart my sample average is from the mean that was believed to be. Again, the diagram that I drew earlier, if this is 2.25, is 3.31 really close, or is it really far out here? If it's really close, it probably does belong to this distribution. If it's really far out here, it probably belongs to a different distribution with a higher mean that's closer to 3.31. That's the basis behind what we're going to be doing.